You're watching Infosec Bytes, a crash course in information security for journalists. We're based at the Center for Investigative Journalism in London and supported by the Logan Foundation. This is an introduction to the Tails operating system, a purpose-built, security-focused operating system which you can use to protect your journalistic work. This video is provided for information only. It cannot replace the advice of a trained security professional. If lives or safety depend on your security, please seek the advice of an expert. The Center for Investigative Journalism is a pioneer in providing expert information security training services to journalists and journalistic institutions. To consult with an expert through the CIJ, or to arrange a CIJ training session, contact the address on screen. The tutorial you're watching is part of a series on the Tails operating system. The rest of the videos in our series show you how to download, install and use the Tails operating system. You can watch them in any order you like, but we recommend you watch them in the correct order. Click or tap on the pop-up message to access the playlist. If you've been watching previous InfoSec Bytes videos, you will have learned how to encrypt your communications with Signal, how to browse the web anonymously with Tor browser, and how to securely erase and encrypt your data. But as we've drawn your attention to over the course of our videos, all of these tasks are performed on Windows, Mac OS, or commercial smartphone systems like Android or iOS. And, as we've explained, there are issues with these operating systems if you are doing work which requires maximum privacy and control over your data. All of these systems, having been designed for convenience, neglect key security and privacy features. They are geared towards mass market consumers, not investigative journalists. Most notably, Windows 10 has a controversial feature which logs all of your keystrokes and sends a record of everything you type to Microsoft. So even if you use encryption software, it can't help you if your operating system betrays you. This is where Tails comes in. What is Tails? Tails is a specialist operating system which is designed for maximum security and privacy. Running on your laptop or desktop computer, it is a secure alternative to Windows or Mac OS. If you use Tails, you use it instead of those systems. You don't have to pay for Tails. It is completely free and available to download on the internet. You may have heard of the family of free operating systems called GNU Linux. Tails is a GNU Linux OS. If you're using Tails, then you are using a version of Linux. Many Linux operating systems try to compete with Windows or Mac OS. Tails is very different. Tails takes Linux and then radically alters the way everything works, from networking to file storage, for maximum privacy and security. It then adds a custom suite of encryption software with the safest, most secure presets. It is tailor-made for the kind of work journalists do. You may have heard that Linux is really difficult to use, but that's simply a myth. While it might be a bit of a headache to get hold of Tails and get it up and running, once you do, everything is ready to go. It has a modern OS design and a very intuitive interface. It actually makes everything a lot easier and also much safer. The name, Tails, is actually an acronym. It stands for the Amnesic Incognito Live System. Let's unpack this, because it's a good way of understanding how Tails works. So what is a live system? Simply put, a live system is an operating system that runs off a DVD or a USB. In the old days, operating systems like Windows or Mac used to come on installed disks, for example floppy disks or CDs. You would put them in your computer and install the operating system onto your hard drive. And from then on, you could boot the OS on your hard drive, and you could put the installed disks away, saving them for if something went wrong, and you had to reinstall the OS again. More recently, operating systems are distributed as downloads. You can download Windows or Mac OS and install it from the download. But it's still something you install. It runs off your hard drive. Live systems are different. They were invented as a way of trying out alternative operating systems without making any changes to your computer. With a live system, you have a removable media, like a USB, and the entire operating system lives on that. You can download a live system, write it onto the USB, insert it into the computer, and turn it on. Your computer doesn't load your native operating system from your hard drive or install from the USB. Instead, it simply boots from the live USB into a new OS. Because they run from a USB, live systems run entirely in your computer's RAM, in the short-term memory of your computer. They can do this without ever looking at your system's internal hard drive. In fact, with a live system, you could remove the hard drive from your machine, and you'd still be able to boot from the live USB. Likewise, because the operating system is on a USB, the computer is more or less interchangeable. You can potentially boot your live system on any computer you like. All of this gives live systems some very attractive properties for a secure operating system. For one thing, they're very portable. With a traditional OS, you have to bring a whole computer around with you. With a live system, you can, if you want to, just carry around a USB and use whatever computer is available to you. It is also entirely transient. The computer is just a way of accessing your live system. It is as if it is temporarily possessed by an OS that is not its own. When you are finished, your live system makes no changes to the host machine and leaves no trace that it was ever used. All of this leads up to another one of Tail's properties, A, for amnesic. What does amnesic mean here? It means that Tail forgets everything every time you shut it down and turn your computer off. With a traditional OS, each time you boot up your computer, it resumes where you were last. All of the files you were working on are still there. All of the changes you made are still there. But live systems aren't like this. Each time you turn them on, they load the OS completely fresh, as if it was the first time. And you can make changes or work on files, but as soon as you shut the computer down, it forgets all of these. The next time you boot, everything will be gone. It will be as if it was the first time you booted it, all over again. It's easy to see how this could be inconvenient, but Tails turns amnesia into a feature, an extremely valuable one. Why? For one thing, if your computer is infected with malware, on a normal computer, that malware stays on your computer until you notice it's there and remove it. But with Tails, it is now much harder for that malware to stay on your computer from one session to the next. Once you shut the computer down, the malware is dumped along with everything else. When you boot up again, it's gone. For another thing, perhaps you want to work on ultra-sensitive documents, and you do not want to leave any traces. On a regular operating system, because of the problem of data remnants, you run the risk of leaving traces of those documents all over your computer. But with Tails, everything is ephemeral. Running entirely in your computer's RAM, it never touches your hard disk. When you're finished working and you shut the computer down, everything in the RAM is dumped. No traces remain of the work you were doing. This makes Tails a much safer way to interact with documents that you're not sure about. Tails is even more amnesic than a normal live system would be. You see, when your live operating system is running, since it runs in RAM, it stores your encryption keys and the files you're working on in RAM. RAM is short-term memory. Once the power is turned off, any data stored in RAM degrades quite quickly and becomes unrecoverable. But there's still a grace period of a few minutes during which it is not fully degraded and could be recovered. So, with a normal live system such as, say, Ubuntu, once it turns off, the data that was stored in RAM takes a few minutes to disappear properly. Those few minutes can make all the difference. If you live in a country where you're worried about your home or office being raided to seize your computer or stop your investigative work, you need to be careful. In a raid situation, police can use aerosols to deliver liquid nitrogen directly onto your RAM components, freezing them to prevent the data in them degrading. Once the computer is returned to a lab, they can then perform what is called a cold boot attack, recovering any data that was still in the frozen RAM at the time of the computer being shut down. If you had an encrypted disk unlocked when you shut the computer off, then this could include your encryption keys. So it is possible for a well-resourced adversary, using this method, to gain access to your encrypted files. To guard against this, Tails has a special emergency amnesia security feature, a shutdown sequence that forensically wipes your RAM each time, making sure to get rid of all traces of data before the computer turns off. The security feature is even jerry-rigged to initiate in an emergency situation. So if you live somewhere that you have to worry about the police smashing down your door, you can just pull the Tails USB out of its port, and this will trigger an emergency shutdown sequence. So that's why Tails is an amnesic live system. This all sounds great, you might say, but I don't just do web browsing and email. How am I supposed to work on a long-term project? It's completely impractical if the OS forgets all of my files from one session to the next. Tails addresses this. By default, the Tails system is fully amnesic and will forget everything as we've just described. But if you like, you have the option of enabling what's called persistence. When you do this, Tails sets aside a space on the USB and fully encrypts it using a passphrase of your choice. Then, when you boot up Tails, you have the option of either leaving this encrypted space locked and booting a completely amnesic session, or of unlocking the encrypted space. When you unlock it, there will be a special folder called Persistent. Files that you place in Persistent will be remembered even after you shut down the computer. But files left anywhere else will still be erased on shutdown. This allows you to use your Tails as you would a normal operating system, selectively retaining some files between sessions, and yet allowing everything else to be safely and cleanly forgotten. Now we come to the incognito aspect of Tails. Tails is an incognito system because it uses Tor to protect your anonymity. If you've watched our video, Introduction to Tor, you'll know all about Tor and how it works to protect your anonymity. And you'll know about Tor Browser, a special browser which runs over the Tor network, which you can use on macOS and Windows to browse the World Wide Web without giving away your identity or your location. If you haven't watched those videos, we recommend you watch them. Click or tap on the pop-up message and find them in the list. But Tor Browser on macOS or Windows has severe limitations. One of these is that when you use Tor Browser, only your actions within Tor Browser are anonymous. Let's look briefly at why that is. When it starts up, Tor provides a special path to the Tor network, and only network traffic that is configured to use that path is protected. So once network traffic goes into that path, it is safely conveyed to the Tor network, and from there, it is anonymized. Tor Browser, of course, is configured to send all of its traffic over this path. Traffic that does not use that path does not go over the Tor network and is not anonymous. So if you use a different browser, such as Firefox or Chrome, or if you use a different application, such as Outlook, or Mail, or iTunes, or Office, or any application that accesses the internet, these applications are not configured to use the special path to the Tor network, and therefore do not go over Tor. They can freely connect to the internet unprotected, and often do so without your knowledge or consent, revealing your identity and location to anyone who wants to see it. So, your system is basically wide open. You might take extraordinary care to make sure you perform all of the activity you want to be anonymous inside the Tor browser, but, for example, it just takes one slip-up for you to accidentally log into your anonymous email account using the wrong browser, and then you've given away your real IP address and your real identity and location. So how is Tails different? Instead of just one application set up to use Tor, Tails incorporates Tor into the entire operating system. Tor is an intrinsic part of how Tails does networking. Not just Tor Browser, but all of the applications that come built into Tails, such as Tails Email Client, Thunderbird, and Tails Chat Client, Pigeon. And not only that, but Tails blocks all other network traffic. It uses a firewall to prevent any other application from connecting to the open internet. Only Tor traffic can connect. So even if you were running an application that was not configured to use Tor, even if it tried to sneakily connect to the open internet, Tails would block it, preventing the data from escaping onto the internet and revealing your location and identity. Tails has basically made using Tor, if not accident-proof, then accident-resistant. It is much harder to inadvertently compromise your anonymity while using Tails, allowing you to use the internet anonymously with more confidence and ease. So that's the incognito aspect of Tails. But Tails is not just amnesic or incognito. Unlike Windows or macOS, where lots of the most essential encryption software does not come built into the machine and has to be downloaded and installed, Tails comes loaded up with built-in encryption software. All of the encryption features that are add-ons on other systems are standard features on the Tails OS, as they should be. It's therefore really easy, for example, to encrypt an external hard drive, or to securely erase a file, or to send an encrypted email. Once you have Tails, you can get started doing all of these things right away. If this sounds good to you, you're probably already wondering how you can get hold of Tails. And in the next video, we're going to show you how to do exactly that. Be aware, though, that installing Tails can seem quite complicated, especially if you're new to Linux. In order to install Tails, we have to download a file from the internet, and then use a special procedure to create a bootable USB from that file. And then we have to set up the computer to boot from that USB. Don't be intimidated, though. If you follow the steps, you will see that it's not that difficult. And installing Tails is by far the most complicated thing to do. Once you have Tails installed, it is extremely easy to use, and you won't look back. So, to find out how to download and install Tails on a USB, watch the next video in this series, Getting Tails. The following videos in this series explain all of the other aspects of Tails and how to use all of its features. To watch these videos, click or tap on the pop-up message and choose the Tails video playlist. Thanks for watching Infosec Bytes. If you found this video useful, please share it widely with your colleagues and co-workers. To support the Center for Investigative Journalism with a donation, please visit tcij.org/donate. And if you would like to watch our other videos, please go to infosecbytes.org or subscribe to our channel below.